Welcome to the second part of this first chapter, Units and Measurement. So in the second part, I will be solving around 10 to 15 questions, and these 10 to 15 questions are basically from dimensional analysis. Okay, so from question number 33, 34, 35 and 36 and 37, all are about write the dimensions. Sorry, 34, 35, 36, 37 of the dimension. 35 is dimension of self inductance, 34 is self inductance, 35 is dimension of torque, 36 is CR, it denotes capacitance and resistance. The dimensional formula CR is time period tau. And 37 is the dimension formula of angular momentum MVR. So these are all about the dimensional formulas only in 33 it is asked that according to Newton's law, the viscous force acting between layers, liquid layer of area A and velocity gradient is del B by del Z is given by F is given by eta sorry minus eta a del b by del z. Then eta is called coefficient of viscosity. The dimensional formula of eta dimensional formulas. So here also how you can find the dimensional formula of eta. So eta will be nothing but f into del z divided by a del b. And here del z is what this is velocity gradient del b by del z, velocity gradient, a is area. So now I will keep on calculating what will be the units, sorry, dimensions of every quantities, right? So I will put one by one. So let's put dimension of force is nothing but dimension of force is m l t minus 2 divided by I'm getting as l square area, and this whole term I'm treating as del b by del z. So I'm getting as velocity gradient, which is nothing but only T inverse. So finally I'm getting the dimension as M L minus 1 T minus 1. So you have to remember like this. Once you know the formula is given, apply each dimension and you can get this dimensions. But here the one thing you need to know, the dimension analysis, which is very important in this chapter, and questions are frequently coming from dimensional analysis. So what is dimensional analysis? In dimensional analysis, there are three dimensional analysis, you know. One is to check the correctness. Okay, let's discuss one by one. To check the correctness, to establish a relation, and what are the dimensional analysis? Number one, to check the correctness. Correctness of an equation. So this is a very easy type of question. Generally doesn't come in need. Why it doesn't come in need? Because it will be given like this: S equal to ut plus half a t square. Compare this. Check this equation whether it is correct dimensionally or not. Correct or not. So you have to calculate the left hand side dimension, which is nothing but n0 l1 t0, and you will also get this everywhere here. U into t, u dimension is lt inverse into t, so this t inverse will get cancelled out. So lt, sorry, u is lt inverse, okay, and then t, so t total will get cancelled, only l will be red. So plus again a lt minus 2 a t2. So again this will be l. So here two l's are coming, but I can say dimensionally it is l, which is nothing but equal to the LHS. So just you have to find out the dimension of LHS and RHS, then you can say equation is correct. And to establish the relation, this is having values in NEET exam, because questions are frequently coming 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43 also. Sorry, 42 is not there, 43. So maximum questions in this part I will cover from dimensional analysis. So here, what is the point to learn? To establish the relation between physical quantities, between physical quantities. This is the very important and conceptual thing, between physical quantities. So what is there in this application? This application is that it will be given, suppose A is a physical quantity which depends on B and C. So initially I don't know how does A depend on B and C, so I'll write like this, and then I will apply. Suppose it is a power is there, so A suppose depends B to the power X and C to the power Y, then I will calculate for XY, and then I will tell what is the relation between ABC. So to do this, I will write the dimension of A first, and the dimension of B, and the dimension of C. Then I will compare. Then after comparing, I will get the value of X, I will get the value of Y, and finally I can say what is the relation between ABC. I will be solving this type of problem. And third application is nothing but to change one unit to another unit, which is again is easier application. So I will be discussing now onwards 38, 39. The questions are from the second application, which is nothing but to establish the relation between physical quantities. So what is there in 38 is given that a physical quantity of dimension of length that can be formed out of cg and e square by 4 pi epsilon 0, where c is velocity of light, g is universal gravitational constant, and e is charge. So three quantities are there, and it is saying length, a physical quantity is of dimension of length, that means it's a length depends on three quantities given, so find out a relation between them. So in this type of problem, again I said you have to write all these given things. What is given? Who depends on whom? That means here you have to write who depends. Here depends a length depends on how many quantities are there. One quantity is c, means a velocity. Another quantity is gravitational constant, okay, and another quantity is given as e square upon 4 pi epsilon 0. It is a constant, so I can only write e square. So I'm writing like this. So here it is the first step. Everything is given. L is depending on light velocity, gravitational constant, and this quantity. So you have to write all these dependencies, means who depends on whom. Then you just start solving. Okay, let's solve. So I can write like this. Now I said in second step, just expand every quantity in terms of dimension. So L having dimension of L1 and T0, because it's a length, so will be okay. I can write equal to a constant. I can multiply a constant. I can delete this proportional sign. So equal to a constant K is there, so leave it as it is. C, what is the dimension of C? Again, you know dimension of C is LT inverse. So I'm giving the value as A. Okay, then coming to gravitational constant, I know the dimension of gravitational constant. What is the gravitational constant? Gravitational constant dimension is m-1 l3 and t to the power minus 2. I'm giving it as B. And what about C? The dimension of total e square by 4 pi epsilon 0, which will be nothing but this term will be nothing but m l q t minus 2 m l q t minus 2. So these are the dimensions I have written, and so values I will get as a. I'm not solving, because how to solve here, you have to solve like this. Here m is 0, but here m is minus b, here m is c, so minus b plus equal to 0. You also can write like this. So my m is 0, here 0, here minus b, so minus b plus c equal to 0. Here l is 1, here l was, here l is a, here l is 3b, here l is 3c, so a plus 3b plus 3c equal to 1. T again 0, so t minus a, minus 2b, minus 2c, so minus a, minus 2b, minus 2c equal to again 0. So I got 3 equation, and for 3 equation is sufficient to get the value for a, b, c. Here I am not doing in detail because it is time consuming. So finally I will get the value as whatever the l was given in my question, depending that I will get the values half half minus 2. So I can write 1 by c square root over of g e square by 4 pi epsilon 0 half. That means only for the light velocity, means for a will get as, I will get abc, right? So for light velocity I am getting as minus 2, so that's why c is coming down, so 1 square. So for b is I am getting as half, and c is I am getting as half, so they both are half. So g, and it is the quantity g, and this is your quantity, I am getting half up, so I am giving half, and this is minus 2, so I am bringing it down here, so I am getting the relation. Okay, this is the catch. So nothing but the dimensional analysis. Using dimensional analysis, you can establish a relation between any quantities accordingly given into the question. So in question number 39 also same thing is there. Planck's constant, the speed of light, and Newton's gravitational constant are three fundamental constant. Then which of the following combination of these has dimensional of length? So this type of question will come where instead of mass, length, time, they will give another three quantity as fundamental quantities. Then they will ask a quantities to derive in terms of fundamental quantities. So here you have to think, if instead of mass, length, time, Planck's constant, it is a very, very important question. So this type of question may create issues for you. So please be attentive during solving this type of question. So what will be there? So instead of mass, length, time, here it is given Planck's constant, speed of light, and gravitational constant are the fundamental units. Then find out the dimension of length. So how to solve? Again, you have to solve. You don't know the relation between them, so you have to solve using dimensional analysis. So how to do dimensional analysis? Again, you have to do like this, as I did in before. Again, here you have to do like this. According to this equation, I need to calculate the dimension of L, which I don't know, and that depends on Planck's constant, and that depends on light velocity, and that depends on gravitational constant. So you have to write like this, and again you have to write those powers, and you have to again expand everything as I did. I'm not doing here again, so I'm just doing the next step. It will be m0 l1 t0. So again I'm expanding these things, so it will be Planck's constant. Just I'm putting the dimension of Planck's constant. What is the dimension of Planck's constant? It is nothing but m l2 t minus 1. So I'm writing m l2 t minus 1 a, light velocity is lt inverse, B, and gravitational constant is nothing but m minus 1 l3 t minus 2, m minus 1 l3 t minus 2. So now again I will expand, I will get the values of a, b, c. after solving I am getting, I am here not solving for u, so here I am getting a and b as half and c as minus 3/2. So what the formula finally I will get, length equal to this proportional design, or I will use a constant k, root over of h and g, because both I am getting as half, divided by c 3/2. C I got as minus 3/2, means this power, velocity, light velocity. Hg I am taking as a, b, sorry, here a and c will be half. A and C will be half. B is minus 3/2. So this is the formula. So after solving only, I will get this. Okay. So now the next question is, what is the next question? In the very next question, it is given that again same thing. It's 40. If the dimension of critical velocity and of a liquid flowing through a tube is expressed as eta density and radius. So eta density and radius are the coefficient of viscosity of liquid and density of liquid and radius of this respect. Then the values are given. So again, here also we have to solve these things. Here it is given as who is depending, the critical velocity is depending on whom, on eta, on density, on radius. Then to find out the relation. So again, I'm giving the answer of this question instead of solving this, because this all are same type of question. So what is given here? It is given velocity. Velocity depends on whom? Velocity depends on eta, suppose A, and velocity depends on density, suppose B, and velocity depends on radius, suppose C. So it is saying that, and just put on every dimension, you have to know the dimension of coefficient of viscosity, you have to know the dimension of density, you have to know the dimension of radius and dimension of velocity. Put all these dimension, it is LT minus 1, and eta, put the dimension, for density, put the dimension, and for radius, put the dimension. After putting all these dimension, you solve for A, B, C. Here I am getting the answer as C. That is, I will get value of A is 1, value of B is minus 1, and C is minus 1. So you have to solve using dimensional analysis. So now I am coming to the next question. Again, 41 question is also like this. 41 is given if force, velocity and time are taken as fundamental unit, then dimension of mass is theirs. So again, here I don't know what is the relation between force, mass and among these quantities. So I will write, I need to calculate the dimension of mass where it is a derived quantity according to this question. Okay, it is a derived quantity and depends on force, velocity and time. So I'm giving A, B, C. So again, I will give the dimension of force, give the dimension of velocity, give the dimension of time. So I will get the answer here. I'm directly doing the answer. So M will be M1, L0, T0. Force will be ML, T2 minus 2. Velocity is LT inverse. Time is T. So A, B, C. And expanding, after expansion, I will get the answer as, this is the answer, means I will get force into velocity minus 1, number 41, right? So 41 I will get force into velocity b minus 1 into t. So these definitions I am getting, which is nothing but the correct answer is D. The correct answer is D, 41. So these types of means 38, 39, 40, 41, 42. So approximately 5-6 questions I have solved from dimensional analysis. So it is very, very important in these types of problem. You have to carefully solve this dimensional analysis problem. You have to put all these dimensions and once you have successfully put all the dimension, then you can easily find out a relation between them. In the 42, it is given the density of a material in CGS unit is 4 gram centimeter minus 1 in a system of unit in which the unit of length is 10 centimeter and the unit of mass is 100 gram. The value of density of the material is, this is not actually a neat question, it is a mains question, it is clearly written mains 2011. So since I will discuss this question, so for this question you have to remember one thing. If this is the application from one unit conversion to another unit conversion, so for this type of problem you have to remember the formula. Here I'm writing the formula, it is the very much important formula, that is nothing but n1 u1 equal to n2 u2. That is, suppose it is in one unit, so it is in another unit, so now I will be easily converting from one unit to another unit using this formula. So here it is given that n1 is 4, u1 is, it's saying gram per cm cube, n2 is saying, I don't know n2 is how much, but u2 when unit is 100 gram divided by 10 centimeter cube, it is saying like this. So here CMQ is CMQ will get cancelled, gram gram is getting cancelled. So finally, I will get as N2 equal to 40. So this is the only formula I need to use here to solve this type of problem. So N2 is 40 means the correct answer is C. And 43, again, the velocity of V time T given by relation where ABC are constant, the dimension of ABC will be. So here you have to find out the dimension. Again, by comparison, because I can compare the equation what is given, V equal to 80 plus B by T plus C. That means, I'm doing it for you. That means it is given 43 is given V equal to 80 plus B by T plus C. So find out the dimension of A and B. So this type of question is asked means you just go on calculating like this. Okay, so you can solve like this. 80 is nothing but, okay, this equation is given means it is a valid equation. So it is a valid equation means this will carry the dimension of velocity and this will carry the dimension of velocity. So I can write 80 equal to dimension of 80 equal to LT inverse. If LT is LT inverse, so dimension of A is LT minus 2. Easily I can get. And similarly I can write for B plus for another term. Okay, for another term. C is a constant, leave it. So for B by T, again it is LT inverse. And for B, it is only L. So this is the way I need to solve this type of problem. So again, it is very, very easy, but it seems like difficult. 43, the answer is, correct answer is B. So I got this B as correct answer. So 44, an equation is given like this, P plus A by B square equal to B into absolute temperature, theta by B. Okay. Then if AB are constant, the dimension of A will be, okay. In 44, again, the same type of question is given, P plus A by B square equal to B theta by V. Theta is in temperature. Theta means temperature by V. V means volume. V means volume. So it is a given formula and ask that if A or B are constant, if A and B are constants, so find out the dimension of constant, the dimension of A will be, dimension of A will be, again you have to solve like this as I did in previous case. Okay, so how to solve? So you can write like this, P plus A by B square, right? So what is given, the dimension of A by B square will be, the dimension of A by B square will be, dimension of, it is P, okay, So I can write the dimension of P stands for pressure. So dimension of A by B square equal to the dimension of pressure, which is nothing but dimension of M pressure per M L minus 1 T minus 2. So it is the dimension of pressure. So again, B square, B is LT, B is what? Volume. So volume means, you're not velocity, volume means L cube. So it will be L to the power 6. So dimension of A is coming as, so I mean to say here what is given, temperature, volume, B, nothing to worry. I'm calculating directly A by B square carries the dimension of pressure, then A carries the dimension of, I'm writing the dimension of M L to the power 5 T to the power minus 2 simply. So 44 is over. 45, which of the following is a dimensional constant, means relative density, refractive index are Poisson's ratio, all are three are ratio, therefore they are dimensionless constants. So one, relative density is dimensionless constant, and but the gravitational constant is having dimensions, right? So I can say in 45, which of the following is dimensional constant? That means gravitational is a dimensional constant. A refractive index and Poisson's ratio and relative densities, these are not dimensional, these are dimensionless. So 46, again, turpentine oil is flowing, duty of length L and radius R, the pressure difference between the two ends of the tube, the velocity of oil is given by this much, P R square minus X square by 4VL, where V is the velocity of the oil at distance X from the axis of the tube, the dimension of eta. Again, it is, the question is looking very much complex, but same dimension analysis will solve it for you. And for dimension analysis, what you have to do, you have to analysis every and each quantity according to dimension. So here it is asked that the dimension of eta, so that dimension of eta will be the 46. The dimension of eta will be nothing but, you have to write dimension of pressure, dimension of radius, dimension of velocity, dimension of L. So I can write that dimension of eta equal to nothing but, I know P R square X square, R square minus X square by 4VL. So just I'm going on adding all these dimensions. P is nothing but M L minus 1 T minus 2. R square minus X square will be nothing but simply length L square divided by 4 is nothing but V, velocity, length. So LT inverse and length is only L. So I'm solving this. After solving this, I'm getting M L minus 1 T minus 1. So these things I'm getting. So it is the equation, but after putting all these dimensions, I'm getting the correct answer. So 47 is given that the time dependence of a physical quantity is P is given by P equal to P0 exponential minus 80 square, where A is a constant and T is time. The constant A is dimensionless or has dimension of dash, four options are there. So try to understand the question. 47. Given that P equal to P0 e to the power minus alpha T square. It is asking that what is about this alpha. So let's calculate about this alpha. So alpha T square, I can write like this. Alpha T square is not having dimensions. Okay. So I can write like this. Alpha T square is dimensionless. It implies that I also can write that alpha equal to 1 by T square. So alpha will carry a dimension of 1 by T square, which is nothing but T to the power minus 2. So 47, I am getting the correct answer as T to the power minus 2, which is nothing but option B. this part 2 also I have covered. In this part 2 I have covered the dimension and analysis, and all these questions since last 30 years I have discussed in unit and dimension. It will help you to practice this chapter for your NEET exam in 2021. In the next video I will be going to kinematics, that is motion in one dimension. So gradually I will be putting each and every chapter in single videos, where I will cover all these questions which is already asked in the NEET exam in last 30 years. So thank you for watching me and listening to me. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.